Howdy everyone, today we are integrating Appsmith, the leading open source low-code platform for internal tools, with Azure Entra ID, which is formerly known as Active Directory, using SAML single sign-on to provide secure, streamlined access for your organization's user to Appsmith's powerful apps and dashboards. Let's first take a look at the prerequisites because we have a couple of them. First, you'll need an Appsmith Enterprise instance with an SSL certificate on, and also an Azure account with permissions to create enterprise applications in your organization. With that, we'll be able to achieve today's topics, which are: first, create and configure Azure Entra ID enterprise application, and second, register SAML single sign-on Entra ID in Appsmith. So let's dive and see how that is done. All right, here we are in Appsmith Enterprise Edition, and let's go to the settings to find the SAML authentication information. In the left menu, you will find the authentication section, and there you will see SAML 2.0. Click on the enable button, and there you will see two very important values, the redirect URL and the entity ID, and down below you're going to see some fields to enter some information that we will do later on. So stay on this page because we're going to need these values, as I said, on the Microsoft Azure site. So let's go there. Let's go to Microsoft Azure, and there, let's first make sure that we're on the right tenant. Go to Microsoft Entra ID, and there you will see your Manage Tenants option. Click over there, and there you will see all of your tenants. Now, I just have one, but make sure that you are on the right tenant where you want to create the application that's going to be integrated with Appsmith. The way you do that is very easy. Just click on the one you want to make the default tenant, and click on the Make Default Tenant button. Now, again, in my case, I'm just going to be using the default one that I have. So with that said, let's go back to the home and find the enterprise application section. Now, if you don't find this option, you just click on the search bar and find for the enterprise applications. So once there, you will see a list of applications. Select the one that you want to use to integrate with Appsmith or create a new one. In my case, I don't have one, so I'm just going to create new application, and we'll see the bunch of different types of applications that Microsoft Azure can provide. But in our case, we're not going to use any of this. We're going to create our own application. So click on that button, enter the name, I'm going to call it Appsmith, and then select the third option that says integrate any other application that you don't find in the gallery. This is going to be a non-gallery app. That makes sense because Appsmith is not listed there. So click on the create button. This is going to take a few seconds, and there we will gonna go to the application and enter our single sign-on SAML information that we have on this page right here. Okay, it's going to take a couple of seconds for Azure to create the application. There you go, and we will go to the application dashboard. There you will see the setup single sign-on option. Click on Get Started, and we will land on the option to select which type of single sign-on method we're going to be setting up. Let's select SAML. And once there, we're going to have to enter a lot of information. So let's go step by step. This is easy, all right? The first one is the basic SAML configuration. Click on Edit, and then we will need to enter the identifier, which is the entity ID, and the reply URL. Click on Add Identifier on the first section, and there you will enter the entity ID that we got on the SAML page here on Appsmith. Make sure to copy this, the entity value. Copy that, go back, paste it, there you go, easy. Second one, pretty much the same. Let's go back, click on the redirect URL, copy that value, paste it over there, and that's it. We don't really need to enter any other information here on the optional values. So let's just close this by saving, not closing. Very intuitive UI, so click on save, and that's going to save that information for our basic single sign-on configuration. All right, now we can close because it's saved. No, I'll test later. All right, now the attributes and claims. We have to do some changes here, very simple. Let me explain because it's pretty straightforward. Basically, we want to reference or identify the users via email address, both in the Appsmith site and also on the Azure for this SAML integration we're working. So the way we do that is by the unique user identifier value. So we want to make sure that, again, we're going to be mapping the email address, all right? So make sure that the name identifier format is selected to the email address. But in this case, right now, the email address is mapping to the user attribute called user.userPrincipalName. That's what I want to change. We want to change that to be the, again, email address of the user that we're going to be referencing via SSO authentication. So in my case, in my particular case, I'm storing, and I think this is default for Azure, I'm storing the user primary authority email address on that field. But if in your application and in your Azure Active Directory or Entra ID, you have the information saved in a different field, again, make sure to just to map to the email address. That's all we want to achieve. Again, both Appsmith and this tenant application, we want to reference the users by their email address. That's all we want to do. So click save, and we're gonna go back to the claims information. Let's close this because we did the change that we need, and that should be it. Now, in this third section where it says SAML certificates, there is this app federation metadata URL. This we're gonna need, and we're gonna grab some values from that XML and then integrate into Appsmith. But this is the first step. We just finished the first step. This is all we need to do in the Azure side to have our SAML application ready to be integrated with Appsmith. Now let's go to the second step. All right, so now let's register the Entra ID into the Appsmith site. So like I said, let's copy this App Federation metadata URL. Let's copy that and open it on a new browser. Now this is gonna show us a XML information about our application in Azure. And we're gonna grab some values from there to copy it into Appsmith. All right, so the first thing we're gonna need to copy is something called the entity descriptor. Let's find for that, and these value names are also you can also find them in the documentation, which you can find in the description of this video. So it's not going to be hard for you to find exactly what we're looking for. And over there, what we're looking is for the attribute called entity ID. So that's what we're going to copy here. Make sure to copy the entire URL. And once we go back to Appsmith, we're going to paste that into our identity provider page here. So in the authentication page we were in the SAML section, go to the IDP data tab, and there we're going to paste the identity ID, which is what we just copy from the XML value. Remember, entity description, entity ID. Now let's copy the second value, which is the single sign-on service. Let's find that on the XML, and there you will find actually two XML values, but they have the same name. And actually what we want to copy is the location attribute. Both have the same value, so it's okay which one you pick. Copy that, go back to Appsmith, and that's where we're gonna paste in the single sign-on URL. Perfect. Now let's find the next value on the XML we need for the X509 public certificate. We should find something with the same name, X509 certificate. Again, we were going to find two values in the XML. Copy either of those because they're the same. So make sure to copy it correctly all the way in. There you go. And let's go back to Appsmith and put that over there. There you go. And now on the email, we're going to copy a value. Again, you can find this information in the link in the description. And this is just going to be a reference to the entity value from Azure, which is going to be referencing the email address that we need for the email authentication for the SAML. And that should be it. Now let's click on save and restart. And like the name says, this is going to save our values and restart our server, because actually Appsmith needs to install this information on the server. So we need to restart the server to make sure these values are correctly done. So then everybody can authenticate via your Azure IDP. So let's click save and restart. This is gonna take around 1 or 2 minutes. So don't freak out. It's take some time. As you can see right now, it's saved correctly. And the server restarting process is just happening right now. So again, give it a couple of seconds or a couple of minutes. Don't be scared. And we'll go back as soon as it's done. All right, it just finished. There you go. The server restarted with no problem. And now we got this authentication successful message. That means we are ready to test it out. But before we do that, there's one thing I forgot to mention, which is on your Microsoft Azure application, we have to make sure that the users and groups that we want them to be able to access to Appsmith via single sign-on, they have to give the permissions. I mean, we have to give the permissions for them to achieve that goal. So on the left menu in our application that we created in Azure, let's go to the users and group sections. And as you can see right now, there are no assignments. So if we go to the single sign-on in Appsmith and we authenticate with our Azure credentials, we should get an error because we are not allowed to access this application. So in my case, I only have a couple of users for testing, but in your organization, you probably have a lot of roles and groups and users. So make sure that here, give permissions to those you want to access Appsmith via your single sign-on. That's very easy, right? So I'm just going to select the ones that I have, which is here, info@rocm.storm. And then this other one, which is another testing user that I created, just again, for the sake of testing. I'm gonna give access to those two. Let me just make sure to select them. Select and then assign. Again, you will give to the groups and people that you want to access to Appsmith via your single sign-on permissions over there. And that should be it. Now that we did that, let me sign out here from Appsmith. As you can see, I'm logged in as kevin@appsmith.com, which is my administrative user. So let's sign out. And now you will see on the login page the SAML single sign-on option, the button to authenticate via single sign-on. So let's click over there. And what happened is that since I'm already authenticated in this browser to Microsoft Azure with my Microsoft account, it used the same authentication, and there you go. I just authenticated to Appsmith with no problem whatsoever. If I click on my account, there you go. I'm authenticated as info@rocm.store. Now, probably if in this browser I was not logged in to Microsoft Azure, I would see here on the single sign-on option, a authentication page where I can log in to my Azure single sign-on, enter my user credentials, and then I will be able to access Appsmith. But since I'm already authenticated, that happened pretty quickly, so you didn't notice it. But as you can see now, here I'm authenticated as my user single sign-on, and now I can create my own applications and start accessing what the administrative users created for me. So there you go. That's how easy it is to integrate Appsmith with Microsoft Azure Active Directory or Entra ID now using SAML single sign-on. Now that you have seen how easy it is to integrate Appsmith with Azure Entra ID, start your free trial of Appsmith Enterprise today and experience the power of secure customizable dashboards. Would you like to host Appsmith yourself? Check out our self-hosting videos on running Appsmith on AWS, Google Cloud Platform, Kubernetes, Azure, and beyond. Finally, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more tutorials on building powerful internal tools with Appsmith. And actually, your next video should be on how to set up System for Cross-Domain Identity Management, which stands for SCIM. So you can bring all of your Active Directory users and roles inside Appsmith and keep them in sync. See you on the next one. Take care.